next bit of Blondie. How good's that? I don't know, it's 1979, the day of the year Rasta was born. How's that? The early days, I was just tinkering. All the early days, I was riding for other people and then just making my own boards every now and then. I wasn't really a full-time shaper. It gives you lift. So it creates lift like a hydrofoil. And then when you got it up on a rail, you got two edges giving you hole. That's what. The feedback on this model's been, geez, I can't believe what it can handle. It's that because it is. A lot of this model went up to Indo and the feedback was really good. Oh, it's pretty good, but, you know, it's demanding too because he's such a good surfer. And there's so many other shapers that like throwing boards at him. And I've got to make him the boards that he likes and that go better. I had to create something better than what he was riding to get him to ride my board. That was a challenge. Worked though, paid off. No, I just think, you know the worst trend in surfing is the fucking packaging that they... All this bullshit packaging that they use that they don't need. Like, you know, when you buy a deck rig, right? And it's sitting on a fucking cardboard backing and it's got this plastic coating cover that just gets ripped off and thrown in the bin. You know, or if they're going to do it, if they're going to have all that crap, why don't they have something that's biodegradable that can be actually recycled? Why don't they just give a shit about everything, you know? Here you go, here's a board cave one. Shall we do the board cave one? Let's do that one so the customer can see.